disagree.
We're going to fix this relationship. Culturally. We also have Josh Jacobs on the show, his fellow Bama boy, hanging out with us. He led the NFL in rushing after the break. We'll be back right here on Up and
Everything he's wearing matches. Yeah. But you're going with this,
Since then, number one, locked in, run it up.
So they run properly.
Listen, I've done my best to do proper introductions here on the show and Up and Adams all week long from Super Bowl 57, but no one can do it better than Mark Ingram. Mark Ingram, I'm going to let you bring in our next guest. Go for it.
Man, I'd like to introduce y'all a special guest on the show today, the Bama boy himself, the Mr. Russian title champion himself, Josh Jacobs. About to get that bag, a.k.a. duffel bag boy, because they're going to have to pay my dog. You feel me?
For so.
Yes, sir.
Isn't he a free agent?
Yeah, he's free.
Okay, so what are you looking at? I mean, think about it. Led the league in rushing.
He was
incredible.
Outstanding.
Talk about it.
Well,
take a division rival and let's go.
When you watch the film, I would say this, and we saw a lot of games in that green room. You watch, all you do is watch football on Fox Sundays. And I was lucky enough to be part of the AP voting this year. And so he definitely was, number one, we voted him as not Pro Bowl, all pro.
Mm.
Right? That's got a little something.
That's got weight to it.
It's just one team.
Yeah.
Right. He was outstanding this year. He was outstanding, healthy, protections, but downhill physical runner. For a team that wasn't necessarily always having success, he was always consistently playing well. And so I'm glad he's a free agent. I encourage everyone to look at him, get him out of the West. Maybe we look at him.
Will you look good in orange? I think
yes, indeed.
You and Javonte back for a 1-2. You love a mixed backfield. You love a 1-2.
Well, I like a mixed backfield.
Hey, he
love
him.
And you get to play longer.
Yep, you do.
This that's one why too. I'm on
if you only,
this looks good.
If you only have one car,
yeah,
and that's all you drive,
yeah,
all right, that car is going to wear down. But if you have two cars, and you drive one on the weekend, you drive one Tuesday through Friday, then mix it up. Those cars last forever.
Sounds like a guy who just signed a $100 million contract that can have multiple cars to drive around. All right. Now, Josh, we want to hear from you.
Yeah.
I met you when you were a rookie.
Yeah.
You were quiet. You were calm. You got a little spice to you this year. You are talking, and I love this for you. What went into this year mentally when you look back at it successfully? What was motivating you?
Just, you know, when they didn't pick up my fifth-year option, which I didn't want them to pick up because, you know, just because of the fact that I was like, all right, I'm going to be a year younger, you know, getting to the bag that I want.
Get back to the table,
you know,
sooner.
Things like that. But I knew that it was in my hands at that point, you know, so all the pressure was on me. And however it went, you know, I could live with. So I'm just happy it played out right.
What advice would you give him, Coach?
Look, the one thing he can control, all of us can control one thing, is our tape. And so you just put it on the tape, everything else takes care of himself. And so, no advice. He's put himself in a perfect position. All right? Honestly, you know, I'd want to be his agent because he played well. He was consistent. He can block the pressure. He can run. And, man, he's a physical presence. So we're never not in the market for players like that. And so he's handled what he's needed to handle.
It's true, then. You guys know each other from Bama, I'm sure. I mean, Mark, this is the person you hype most on
my show.
I would
say one thing.
Tell me.
Man, find a place where you can get one of these.
Yep.
Because there's nothing like playing in this game. Right? While we're all doing this kind of stuff, there's a group somewhere meeting right now on Red Zone. Like, they're working on Red Zone today or third down today. And when you have that opportunity to play in this game, then you become obsessed with it. And then you can't leave the game. Then you're like me. You come back because you want to win another one and another one and another one.
Josh, what is this trophy?
It's the FedEx Ground Player of the Year.
Can we please see it?
Yeah, man.
You were with us on behalf of FedEx. Let's talk about it.
Man, so, yeah, it's the FedEx Ground Player of the Year award. I just found out actually this morning that I actually had won. But, man, yes, yeah, it's a dope honor. You know, they donate $20,000 to, you know, HBCUs. And I actually got the opportunity to donate to the first college that I ever went to, which was Langston University. So, man, it's definitely a great honor and blessing for sure.
If we tried to mail that in FedEx, that would cost $1,000. You see how heavy it is?
I couldn't carry that down the stairs.
Let me. Oh my goodness.
Hey, it weighs more than you.
Hey, that
thing, fine though. Hey, you only get that for toting that tater properly. Congratulations, bro. Congratulations.
We're so happy for you, Josh. You have lots to look forward to, of course. Now, everyone was handed a 2022 NFL script. That's what the kids are saying, right? We have a little chapter of what your script was. Let's take a look. What was in the 2022 script for the league's leading rusher, Josh Jacobs? Take me through this play. Go.
Man, I knew when I seen the whole, I knew that the safety had to make a decision. I knew it was over if he didn't make
a
tackle.
Made a business decision. Yeah. So he said he going to live to play another day. Yeah, he ain't want that action.
How
you doing, Josh? Man, I mean, I remember when I seen the hole, I was like, all right, the only thing I got to do is run. I was looking on the screen, though. I was looking for the corner, man. I was like, bro, he fast. I've been seeing him on film the whole week.
Yeah.
You know, so I was looking on the screen, looking for him, see where he was at. But I knew I kind of had it after, like, 30 yards.
Why was Derek so emotional there?
Man, you know, that was a big game, man. It was a big game. You know, it came down to the wire. It was a lot of fans, you know, on Derek at the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
It was a dude with a sign.
Tell that meant something, though.
Yeah, man, it was a dude with a sign. It was crazy because I didn't know if I was going to play in that game or not. Just before the game had started, I had strained my calf literally the Friday's practice, non-contact. So I didn't know if I was going to play or not in that game. And I came out and I was like, man, it was this dude with a sign. And he said, it said something about the Raiders or something about Derek Carr. And I looked at him before the game and I said, thank you, I needed that. And so the game just kind of played out how it did after that.
The guy with the sign is when you come out of the tunnel there, and he's right there to the right, three rows back. We played them five different times.
Yep.
So this guy is a professional heckler, right? I found out his name. And the last time we played there, I left a message in his seat. I can't even use the words. So when he flipped that seat down, like, I heckled the heckler before he got to his seat.
That's dope.
True story.
That's the most Sean Payton thing I've ever. Yeah. Mark's like, yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, that's SP for you, for sure.
When I was talking about how you've gotten spicy, you were outspoken about the Pro Bowl, and this is your quote, "This shit is stupid."
Yeah.
Talk to him. I just saw that play. I see the trophy. Let's go.
Yeah, so, you know, I think the actual day is cool. I don't think people know how much behind-the-scenes stuff that we have to do on the Pro Bowl. You know, you got to be there for really, like, 4 days. And, like, a water balloon toss, like, what is that? Like, you could have came up with something, you know, more creative. But, yeah, I mean, my personal opinion, like, a lot of people don't play hard in it. It's just something that, you know, obviously for fans, but...
Sean, it sounds like somebody who doesn't care about the Pro Bowl wants a Super Bowl.
Well, look, two things.
We have a minute left.
I was part of this coaching the Pro Bowl when it was back in Hawaii. It was tackle. We get all of it. And it's changed gradually, and that's where it is. But I think one of the reasons the younger players that go, and then they get itineraried, and they do all these things, and then you begin to realize, like, the next year, like, I'm good.
Yeah,
like, you know, you end up signing. You end up doing a lot of different things for 4 days. It's an honor to go and to be in it. So pretty soon Pro Bowl is like all pro, just a different award.
Yeah.
And it doesn't mean there has to be a game or, because I was waiting for the potato sack races and the egg toss.
I mean, I love an egg toss. Are you kidding me? This would be great. Okay, Josh Jacobs, we appreciate you. Good luck. FedEx, of course. You led the league in rushing. You have bigger goals, I'm sure, next year. Not a Pro Bowl, a Super Bowl. I just feel a vibe here. I feel like this is, does this look good to everyone on the same team? Do we see these guys wearing orange with this guy with a visor? You in a Broncos visor? I can't quite.
Oh, it'll be right.
Really?
Yeah. It'll be right.